Thank you very much. We are really glad to be here, and we really cherish the opportunity to play in such a wonderful hall. The acoustics are really marvelous. So today when we were rehearsing, we were very impressed with how the sound carried. So you're really privileged having a concert hall like this. Before we go on, I would like to introduce members on the stage. From my far side, Amanda Grimm, viola player. She is originally from Cleveland area. And then Kira Saltman from Texas. Azusa Tashiro from Japan. And Eleanor Barge from Minnesota. Musicians living currently and teaching in Chicago area. Probably will come from Chicago, and I come from Bloomington, from Indiana University.
So we're going to make a slight change from the program. I think you have two pieces by Defia listed there. We're going to move that second Defia work to the second half. We'll open with that. We're going to move on to what we call our Brazilian set right now. We have three individual pieces by different composers, all from Brazil. And the first one we'll be playing for you tonight is called, my personal favorite, it's called Jango. And what Jango is, it's a specific rhythm. And you'll hear it, it'll be very obvious, you'll hear it in the guitar halfway through the piece. But the rhythm was played on a drum that came from Angola, made its way to Brazil. And in more creative times, let's say, it was thought to have mystical powers, both the rhythm and the drum and the dancing that went with it. So it would promote wealth and fertility. And while that sort of mysticism has waned, you can still hear this rhythm in a lot of the traditional music of Brazil. So this is Jango. Thank you.
Anacleto. It's a simple but appealing little tune. It's based on a Scottish waltz, which became a strong influence in this Brazilian form of popular music. This is one of my favorite pieces. I think it fits perfectly to this ensemble. Nostalgic sounding guitar, and as each string instrument take charming little solo back to back. Hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
So the third piece we'll be playing from this Brazilian set of tunes is actually a movement from a larger piece called the Libre Sonatine by Roland Diaz. He is a Tunisian-born French composer who was born in 1955, actually still teaches in Paris at Music Conservatory guitar. He's a famous guitarist, particularly known for his inventive and imaginative improvisations and very long improvisations. This piece is the third movement of this three-movement sonata. He composed it after he had actually had quintuple bypass surgery, very serious medical procedure, and really felt sort of a bout of, this was a reaction to him feeling sort of that he had a second chance, that he was getting a second chance at life, and through his recovery, he felt really alive. And so you'll hear in this piece some sort of crazy mixed meters, and Petar will be going like absolutely nuts with like a million notes. And we will try to keep up, and we hope you enjoy.
Thank you.
The next two pieces that we're going to play for you are both by Astor Piazzolla. Piazzolla was born in Argentina, but he lived all over the world. He lived in France and he lived in New York. And he represented a blend of the tango, kind of traditional tango style, with parts of jazz and parts of classical music. And he invented a new style called Tango Nuovo, New Tango. The first piece that we're going to play is Oblivion. It's super famous. It's been in like a ton of movies. I'm sure you recognize it. It's sort of one of the most beautiful melodies that exists, really. And the second piece that we're going to play for you is a selection from Piazzolla's Four Seasons of Buenos Aires. So he wrote this. He wrote this especially by one concerto. It's been arranged for us. Which you will see. He wrote it as his sort of tango version of Vivaldi's Four Seasons. So the sort of funny thing about it is that we're playing Primavera for tango, which is the spring season, but he drew material from Vivaldi's Autumn because the seasons are reversed in the spring. We hope you enjoy.
Well, your tickets say Petar Jankovic recital, I think, right? That's what says on the tickets that you have. So I decided to play recital. No, I'm joking. Actually, what is going to happen, I had a fantastic idea a few days ago to have a guest artist playing. And that guest artist is really a wonderful Brazilian guitarist and a colleague of mine from Indiana University. And we have a guitar duo, and I said, well, wonderful opportunity. He was available, he wasn't playing any concerts on this date, so I asked him to join us and play a little bit with me, duo, and then play with the rest of the group together, so it's kind of extravaganza. Petar Jankovic Ensemble and PD Guitar Duo, that's the name of the duo that we do. So that's what we are going to do, that Daniel and I are going to play a little bit for you, a little music that we normally play. And we will start with a work that Daniel arranged combining Beatles music and Bach music. And it's called Beatles and Bach. So the order in the program is a little bit also different. And the reason for that is because Paul McCartney, when he wrote Blackbird, he was inspired by Bach's Bourée. That's the piece that inspired him to write that piece. And then Daniel had an idea then to connect many other Bach's or Baroque, actually, works, not only Bach, and combine that with Beatles tunes. So that's what we're going to start with. Well, without further ado, I would like you to welcome our guest artist, Daniel Duarte.
Thank you. Next piece is by an Argentine composer, and the title of this work is Milonga. Milonga is a dance originated between the border of Uruguay and Argentina. And this actually is the origin of tango, of the famous Argentine tango. So, by Jorge Cardoso, Milonga.
Thank you.
different. But you know, with guitars, it's like that. We spend half a concert tuning our guitars. And then the other half we play out tune.
Sorry, listen. The next piece from another Argentinian composer, and it's part of a bigger suite, or Truco suite. The name of the composer is Máximo Emilio Pujol. And me and Pat, we heard this movement once, and we said, we have to play. Right? And then a week later, we heard it.
I remember when we heard it at the master class at IU, one of my students who playing that, and I heard it, and I texted him that very second. I heard his, I said, look, we gotta play this work. It just sounds great.
Exactly. We enjoy playing this one.
Yeah.
So by Máximo Emilio Pujol, Falta in the lyrical tangle. Sing a song. I'm just kidding.
You're gonna whistle the song. Well, it sounds like that.
So this is slightly different guitar. this is a cavaquinho, it's a Portuguese guitar from the 14th century. And this was one of the first guitars that started to come to the Americas. And this would eventually actually become the famous ukulele. This is the grandfather of the ukulele. So we're going to play two pieces here with this instrument. The first one is a guitar classic. Maybe Petar can explain more. Talk about this piece.
It's a piece by Francisco Tárrega that was written for solo guitar, and it's really one of the most famous pieces. It is a Recuerdos de la Alhambra. It's a tremolo piece for solo guitar that became so famous that every guitarist wants to play that piece when they start learning guitar. So we decided to give it a little spin and make it slightly different.
Thank you.
No, this was a Spanish piece
written as a bossa nova, a Brazilian bossa nova. And I'm gonna play actually a Brazilian piece. This mixes different musical cultures in essence. It mixes the origin of this comes from the European polka mixed with African rhythms. And this originated this traditional Brazilian style called choro, actually literally means crying. This one is quite happy. I'm not gonna make you cry today. But it's called Brasileirinho, the little Brazilian. If you watch the Olympic Games, you probably saw it in the ceremony that opened the games. They played this.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So we moved that first piece. Well, it wasn't the first piece, it was the second piece in the program, and we moved it at the end of the concert. So we are going to play two works for you at the end. One is Ritual Fire Dance by, and then just so you know, we're all on the same page. And then the other is Asturias. And Asturias is considered to be, I would say, warhorse of guitar repertoire. That's what I like to say. It's a piece that was written for piano originally, but then soon after was arranged for guitar, and since then it became a guitar piece that we treated as such. And this is that will be arrangement for guitar and string quartet. So, but first we play Ritual Fire Dance by Manuel de Falla.
Thank you.
At the end of this program, as a full ensemble extravaganza, a Brazilian piece, and then after the concert we'll be outside meeting and greeting the audience members. We have CDs, we'll be happy to autograph them or just shake hands and answer questions. I'm sure you'll have a lot of questions as usual, I like to chat. We'll be happy to do that and discuss various aspects of the program tonight. And to the end, we are going to do Brazilian, traditional Brazilian piece. Thank you.
Thank you.